Hold it down. Recognize, nigga. Nobody harder. Rapping the raw.
Break it down. Break it down.
Hold it down.
Recognize. What's up, y'all? The Big Face Gary Show. Shout out to Upper West Side. Shout out to Haiti. PT Guad, my mom's town. Hempstead, Long Island.
Mm-hmm.
His homeboys are here with me. We chilling. And I'm just happy to have Granddaddy IU, infamous legend, you know what I mean?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to start off like this. So I have Finesse here, mm-hmm. and Finesse was telling me he don't want to be held in a chokehold with just being a rapper. He had to get out of his realm to reinvented himself.
Right.
So
he's
thanks
DJ
to Ron.
And the producer.
Yes, thanks to Ron, the producer, my man, the genius behind the camera, we call him the genius. He did some research, and Lord Finesse has an album called The Motown. Right,
yeah.
Now he did, and
crazy.
It's killing the game.
Crazy.
And then you have something called The Essence.
That's a fact.
So tell my viewers and my peoples about The Essence.
It's a compilation album, you know what I'm saying? Me on all the production, I got like some veteran artists, you know what I'm saying? And I got my young boys, you know what I'm saying, that I brought in, you know what I'm saying, that I wanted to introduce to the world. And I figured that, you know what I'm saying, the best way to do that is put them with some brand name artists, so that, you know what I'm saying, they can check for it already. And then once they check for it, they hear them, yo, you know what I'm saying?
So is it being done independently, or
Yeah.
I mean, so whatever you make is your money. You're not letting these people take your money and pimp you.
We did that already.
Yeah, them days is over, I agree. We ain't getting pimped no more.
That shit's dead.
We'll do the pimp walk when we go and hanging out.
Yeah.
Buying houses and doing big shit. Then you see the pimp walk. But we ain't getting pimp no more. Them days is over.
That shit.
Them days is dead over. So
that been over.
So I'm gonna get a little crazy, but you're gonna laugh at me, but I don't care. You may not wanna answer, but you know I gotta try my hand, but I think you're gonna answer.
Right.
You're gonna answer.
Right.
So you wrote one of the illest records of all time. I just heard about it a week ago. The shit called Big Mama.
Big Mama.
My man. You should have spit that shit yourself. Because she monstered that shit.
Yeah.
And I keep turning around, I'm an ex-A&R. So you can write something,
right,
but they may not deliver.
Right, right.
Lil' Kim used to deliver with Biggie Rowe.
Right, right.
And Roxanne, she delivered that motherfucker.
Right, right. Save all the drama, cause here comes the Big Mama. Any who rips Shiny Obama, cause y'all weak ass hoes got me set up. So hookers, get your gloves and yo, let's go head up. Wall to wall, y'all all are four. I don't stall, cause in this brawl, it's when it takes all. A title bout for all the clout. Trying to step to this, it's lights out.
Right. So Fly Ty, the owner of Coachella Records,
right,
just came out the blue and said, I need you to write a record.
Yeah, he was like, yo, I got an idea. I want you to write a song dissing all the female rappers. I'm like, what the fuck you talking about? It's about this every word. Nigga wrote some names down, passed me the paper like some mafia movie shit, like, pass me the paper. Alright. What you saying, what the check looking like?
Of course, that's the next story.
Bow.
And then, he said, yeah, that's what I'm getting. So he said, fuck it.
All right, let's go. You know what I'm saying? So I went, you know what I'm saying? We had to go to Power Play. Of course, I got late the reference
Power
track.
Play is what, a studio? You said Power Play?
Power Play in Queens.
Oh, okay. I heard that studio before, but I've never been.
Yeah, that's
okay,
where,
okay,
like, everybody before the day.
Jam Master Jay worked there too before Power Play?
Nah, he had his own shit.
Okay, rest in peace, Jam Master Jay.
Yes, indeed. But like DJ Doc was the engineer. KRS, everybody who was somebody back in the 80s, you know what I'm saying, early 90s, Power Play.
Okay. So you wrote it. So you wrote it, then you had, did you have to coach her through it?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, I knew it had to be. I knew you had to. She destroyed that shit.
I had to lay the reference track, you know what I'm saying? Bring her in. She was like, hold up.
You going crazy. This bitch is going, hate
yo,
me.
Yo, yo.
Nah, these women are going to hate me.
She was kind of iffy, like, I don't know. And some of the bars, she was saying that shit like, nah, fuck that. You know what I'm saying?
You got to get it, man.
Stand on that shit.
So
that's what it was.
So now we heard all the stories about
it
the
was
trash,
like,
and the pop stuff.
That shit wasn't even about nothing.
Here's a quick question. Did you ever like make up any of the ladies, or do you ever kind of wish you take it back, or is it just that's hip hop?
To me, it was hip hop, and it was just a check.
You know, it was business.
It was never personal with you.
Never.
It's like the mob. People, they never. Say that. Never personal business.
I didn't have nothing against none of them.
None of the ladies.
You know what I'm saying? Because it wasn't even my idea.
It was Black Tie's idea.
But, nevertheless, it was a check.
Ever reach out to you, or it was just that?
Nah, the next time I seen Light and shit, because me and Light was all right, you know what I'm saying? I seen her next time, she was like, nah, my brother, you the enemy.
That's it.
I'm like, words.
I'm gonna keep it real. I'm gonna keep it grand at you. She had to do that. You wrote a monster record. She got demolished on that record, man.
She was saying,
you hear what you were saying on that song?
I know.
You wrote it. She went crazy.
I know.
And you coached her?
I'm saying though, like,
you got paid to do your job.
Yeah.
What you wanna do? Yo, what's the grand? I don't mind that. It's just beef. We cool. No, she did right. I don't spoke to you, but y'all friends now? Have you seen
it? Nah, I ain't seen it no more.
All right, well.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't never seen it no more.
MC Lash has been about 30 years ago. He's moved on. You've moved on. Let that shit go, man.
All these battles going on right now. You know, Rick Ross, 2 Chainz about to go.
I seen that.
Hold up. Fuck that. I don't get him really, on blast. Me and Brian were all the time. And he go, who you picking? God MC, my man Jay-Z, or Biggie?
I looked at me. You can't bail out IU. You got to be straight up.
I'm all big all day. I take Jay.
What I told you. What? Y'all the camera. Oh, my God. On my show.
But remember what Lord Finesse said.
I know Finesse's not on this show. Granddaddy is.
That's right.
My show with my brother, Jay-Z. Jay-Z's the best ever. Yo. I told you that. Leave him alone. And you said he the best ever, right?
I said he is. But if you would have took Biggie's first albums and Jay's first albums, Biggie would have crushed him. That's it. Just the first
You know
two.
What? I'm not going to do that because I don't want to do this. Biggie's not here no more. But I'm just telling you, I'm going with what I've seen and what the world has seen. I'm going to ask her, is Jay-Z the best rapper ever?
Yo. I tell niggas like,
he's more. See, that's my shit. That's right. You're right. You know why? Hello. You know what he just did? That's why you love me? You can't tell Ron nothing about me. That's the best answer in the world, and I respect it. But I'm into loyalty. There's something you did that was great. They said Babs had a deal on the table.
Right.
And you helped her with everything, producing, helped her with her situation. And they said, you cool, but they don't want to have nothing to do with you.
Yeah.
And you told the guy, man, go get that money.
That's a fact.
That's real. You know how big I am on loyalty, man?
She told me, if he ain't coming down, if he ain't with it, I ain't with it. Nah, go ahead, man.
That's great, man. You know how real that is? You know, somebody would have been like, yo, fuck that. I made you. How dare you do me like that?
Nah, man. Just like the nigga that's on this compilation. I didn't sign them. I just told them, listen, man, do your shit. Take this shit. It's an alley-oop. You know what I'm saying?
Who are you talking about, man?
If the God.
Oh, everybody. Whoever it is.
No. The niggas that wasn't on.
Oh, I got you. Okay.
My young niggas that I put on to the shit. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, like, got you.
I didn't sign them. I didn't take no.
Oh, this song brings something to them. Do you? It's not no big deal with me. You don't owe me nothing. You're not signing me. People don't even do that no more, man.
It's an alley-oop. You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
This shit ain't run.
The beats and the production.
Well, you a hell of a, but we're gonna get into that. So now, Ron is bitter about this because he's a Queens fanatic and he's embarrassed. He said MC Shan let it go, man. He still.
Well, Ron said it's story more.
Listen to this story.
What happened was Fat Joe, his thing with KRS.
Right.
KRS was showing all of it. And this is important to get this from you because you are Juice Crew. You Juice Crew. Mm-hmm. That's it. KRS kind of be showing love. He be like, oh, Shan's my man, but you know this and this. But then Shan, I noticed he got on the IG, and he seemed a little mad. He was like, yo, KRS bit my whole style. KRS, I was the first one that was doing the Jamaican inside the music. He said, yeah, Run DMC had it with the other dudes, but it was just a fusion.
Right,
kind of like the
Aerosmith
and the Run DMC thing, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But he was saying how KRS bit his style.
Oh, he ain't paying you no mind. Y'all know how that nigga do. Every time the pressure on that nigga, he go run to fucking England and stay there until the pressure is off and he peek his fucking head out to see whether it's okay. Can I come outside now? Are niggas feeling me again? So tomorrow, y'all gonna hear my story. And I'm gonna tell y'all from fucking the beginning of Chris's whack existence to how he stole my style, how he lied about a whole bunch of shit.
So, and me as a Queens dude, I'd be mad at my man Shane, because I'd be like, yo, you don't gotta look bitter. It was a war. You battled. It was good. You took a L on that one. You know what I'm saying? Right, right, one right. On Nas.
Yeah.
You don't like that, right?
But see,
you
know, like, I saw that. Yeah. The line he said, you said that he was mad because Cats kept hit, tagging
kept
him.
Tagging him in the post.
And he said about the reggae shit. Well, he forgot to mention that he brought up Snow.
Right.
But before that, way before that, he had some shit. Gazoogazang, bong, bugadong.
I remember that shit. I remember that shit
was way back.
I remember that.
You know what I'm saying?
So, I give credit. And you got a unique view on this, man. Because yo, you did some of Chris production, KRS production.
I did a joint for him.
Which was
June
crew,
shit.
Yo, like how?
I mean, I wasn't part of that battle shit. I came after that shit.
Right.
Like, and I don't give a fuck about that. That ain't got nothing to do with me. Really.
They
you know what I'm
put
saying?
You in there, you was tearing shit up.
I came afterwards. You know what I'm saying?
Afterwards, yep.
And it's like when I came there, I didn't know nobody. So it was
right.
Like it wasn't no shit like this is my man, I grew up with him and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like half the nigga, like Kane didn't even fuck with me when I first came there.
Kane's dope.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a fact.
I saw that you were saying that. I also seen that you were saying that you was out before Rock, but then Rakim came out.
No,
and
no. No, I didn't. I wasn't out before him.
Okay.
I was locked up.
I was locked up.
My shit, but I was locked up.
Okay.
I called my man. My man said, "Yo, it's this motherfucker sound just like you, my nigga." It was a shit. So check out my melody. You play that shit to me over the phone.
Turn up the bass, check out my melody, hand out a cigar. I'm letting knowledge be born, and my name's the R. AKA I am not like the rest of them, I'm not on the list. That's what I'm saying, I drop lines like a scientist. My melody's in the code, the very next episode. Have the mic off and distorting, ready to explode. I keep the mic at Fahrenheit, freedom season, make them cola. The listener system is kicking like solar.
I'm like, that shit don't even sound like me. I don't even know, you know what I'm saying? But then when I came out and I got on, everybody was like, yo, this nigga trying to sound like Rakim.
Right.
And I'm like, that shit just like,
over it.
That shit just,
I feel bad for Rakim.
Shit out of
I feel bad for Rakim, because me and Ron talk about this. Like, the Lex Coop was ahead of his time. Rakim was ahead of his time. These young boys is filthy rich now. If Rakim was here, this era spitting the shit he hit, he'd be filthy rich. He don't get no props. They just say he was one of the best, but that don't mean shit when a motherfucker come out next week and got a show doing 100,000 a show. You know what
right.
I mean?
So
that's just crazy.
Said,
Cool G Rap, though.
Yeah, Nori, yeah. And Nori,
Cool G Rap.
Yeah, Cool G Rap, never had a gold album in his life. Never sold 150,000 copies. No 150, 200 copies. But Nori, 200,000 copies, excuse me. Nori made a good point saying that he thinks they should have a pension for these rappers, these old rappers.
That's a fact.
Because then Melly Mel and these guys, they are hanging in there, but they deserve to get a check every month. Why not?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
who's
yeah.
These record labels should have a fund to pay these rappers who came out.
They made motherfucking trillions of dollars so far.
But these kids now are making big
yes.
money. So it's funny you said you was locked up, because I was locked up too.
Right.
Years ago, 99. But
Tekashi
99, I got locked up. I came home, you know.
Damn,
I learned my
I'm talking about early 80s. Like,
oh, nah, I wasn't locked up.
First time I got locked up was 86.
Damn, man. You ain't You learned your lesson, though. You figured it out?
Eventually, as
a couple more tricks, you know.
Yeah, yeah, it's so real. Yeah, you too real, man. I love that. He's so real. Listen, Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Yeah.
What are your views on that? Sit on everything.
I don't even know what's the interest in the nigga. Like, what's the intrigue?
That's what
I said. You should
like,
ask me that question.
I might. Yeah, I might ask you because I've been
curious.
Well, after you finish, I'm gonna ask you. Definitely, because he don't give a fuck.
The nigga has no talent.
Thank you. Trash.
I
bet you he's trash.
He got rainbow hair, and you know what I'm saying? Not for nothing, but you know what that represents.
Yes.
Yeah.
So how is the hood even attracted to that? And standing behind that?
Standing behind
gangsters it. Are standing behind that.
I don't, like, I don't respect that shit. I told
at
you
all.
I don't respect that shit at all. I've been up top. 99R2681. That was the most worst time in my life. So my point is, you it's like he got rewarded for being a rat bastard.
And I ain't telling nobody. I dealt with my situation and came home. Now, big man here said he got something to say. I just met him today. I don't know what he gonna say, and I don't give a fuck. So go ahead and get it, man. What do you think about that Tekashi 6ix9ine situation, man?
I mean, Tekashi 6ix9ine, he's just marketing
tool.
Genius.
That's what she's in.
Right.
But Bronson, Bronson died already, though.
I think he died.
He said it died already. He says it's not working.
I think that kind of stuff don't have no substance. I don't have a dog in a fight. I ain't in the streets no more. I've been jammed up to it all that.
And I heard a lot of that numbers is fake.
Either way, if you notice, it's going away. People was interested when he came home. They just wanted to know what was
right,
going on.
Right, right, right. The curiosity.
Right. But in reality, the loyalty and the real shit still win. You got a Ferrari. Can't drive it. What happened to going back to your hood the way the people love and appreciate you?
Right.
If you can't do that, then you ain't saying nothing.
But they reward him on 11 mil. So what's happening to me is when his kid becomes a kid. So when his kid becomes older, son or daughter, I don't even know what he has, they're gonna say, "Daddy, you a rat?" He's a rat.
Mm-hmm.
He's mm-hmm. a rat.
Yeah.
And Ron, they said the fuck about me. I know. When it was me to go, granddad, I buckled up. I was sad because my mom was hurt. I did my time, came home, and learned my lesson. And it takes people 2-3 times to learn. Granddad manned up. Some people learn the first time. I learned the first time.
Mm-hmm. Was you there for It Was All Good just a week ago? With Too Short, the snitching joint?
Oh, come on. I was there for that session. That song. But I love that record. I love that record, man.
Yeah.
So, granddad, so now, this is the thing. When Rockefeller closed, it was a rough time for a lot of people.
Right.
I'm meaning me too. And my daughter was being born. I had to fight back and reinvent myself.
Right, right, right.
Now, you being one of the legends, something new, doing your thing, you're killing the game, God is good, everything, then you die down. Is that when you said, let me start producing to get back home?
Nah, the thing was, I always was producing.
Oh, okay.
Motherfuckers didn't know that. Because okay. I didn't get the credit for producing my first album.
But you didn't know nothing about the game.
Man. I ain't know.
You supposed to be produced by Granddaddy IU.
But I came in under Biz, under his production.
I was gonna ask you that question too.
Shout out to Biz.
I hope you feel better.
Speedy recovery and all that.
Speedy recovery, we're praying for you.
Yeah. So what you're saying is so you didn't know nothing, you made a lot of the beats.
Yeah, I ain't know shit. I was still on the block. Like I leave the studio and go straight to the block.
So like
you know what I'm saying?
Cool V was working on all the stuff together.
And Doc. DJ Doc.
So now even though we know that like this is past that, you and Big had y'all differences and coming up in the game, you had your differences with everybody, y'all make. But now the Biz wants to do his thing. You give us something that nobody know that you seen with Biz. Maybe a time he stepped in. Maybe a time where he did something dope. Or maybe a time you seen him do something like that. We don't know. That we never heard about Biz.
I ain't gonna say that because he
mad. No, you ain't gotta say something that makes his honor. You wanna blow him up. Something to make you laugh.
Yeah.
Something that we don't know about. Because Biz is a mythical figure. You know what I'm saying? He's all funny. Gotta be like.
The nigga, he's, first of all, the nigga, he could snap like a motherfucker. So you don't want to fuck with him.
He's a snapping king.
You don't want to fuck with him. But nah, he'd do the craziest shit. Like one time he showed up to the office with a doobie wrap and a fucking sundress.
A doobie wrap and a sundress? That's like he was word. In your video
and
fucking
and three stripe pro cads.
Don't give a fuck.
Like, what the fuck are you doing?
Really,
there
nigga?
Ain't no video shoot, no nothing. It's just.
He just want to be crazy.
A regular day. The nigga got a fucking sundress and a doobie wrap. With the fucking all the fucking what's some shit called?
The pins.
The pins, yeah, the bobby pins.
So again, I'm always gonna shout my man out. I got Big the Genius of the camera and Ron the producer who feeds me information and I put it together. You produce for DOS Effects.
Helter Skelter. Now I'm gonna keep it real,
DOS Effects.
Don't you say DOS Effects was dope.
Shitty bop or shitty boop.
Yes, DOS Effects was dope.
I can understand that.
Shout out my nigga Drazy.
Drazy. They had me bugging out for a little minute. But when I went to a club.
But yeah, the impact.
When people started throwing joint on.
Why they stop?
That rhyme wasn't gonna last long anyway, unless you change, reinvent yourself. Skibbity bop or super bop. I just said it can't rap. You know who's rapping like that a little bit now? A little, you know, I'm crazy. You heard this new kid, he got a record, What's Poppin', called Jack Harlow.
I heard of him, but I ain't heard his music.
He white boy. He spit crazy, though.
Yeah.
That one record, crazy, or he's just a white
that
boy.
One record called What's Poppin', you'll do your research on
it. I'm gonna do it.
But Dos Effects, you produced, was it a good, you had a good session with them? You loved it?
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Help the Skelter, I don't know, that one, that was a little deep for me. Did you enjoy that one, too?
Yeah, I mean, like, this is before Ruck was Sean P.
Oh,
saying it was, he was still rock. It was rock and rock. It meant back. It was on a Magnum Force album. I did two joints on there. One was Magnum Force. And the other one was Forget Me Not. Bangers too. Bangers.
So my thing is, so when did you say it? When did you start really saying, let me start producing? Like, it just fell in.
I just do it, you know,
to have fun,
sporadically.
But then you're going back to the block, like you said.
Yeah. Just do what I do.
But just, now, not a lot of people like that. Super talented, go back to the block.
I ain't been rapping lately, you know what I'm saying? I ain't wrote nothing in like a mad long time because I'm like, the game is just so shitty to me. Like,
it's nasty now.
But I still wanted to contribute. So I said, you know what I'm saying? What could I do? You know what I'm saying? To still do something without me spitting. So.
I mean, you ghost wrote for mad people like
me.
I know.
You know what? People don't want to admit that. I've never seen nobody ghostwrite to somebody and say, this is what I wrote for. So that was a shot, and it didn't work. So we tried.
But now,
the Shantae shit, everybody know that's like common knowledge. So
common knowledge.
Because all the backlash that came in. And as a matter of fact, it was MC Light that exposed it. Because they was on some talk show, like the Jane some shit show. They had all the girls, but they had Shawnee backstage.
But how she found out? If it's your team.
I don't know. She like, and she didn't even write that shit. You wrote it. Niggas was like, oh shit.
And then they should have wrote back for one of them. But that's just me saying that. That ain't you, that's me.
What was your relationship with Dana Dane?
That's my man.
Is that really his? He'll talk like that. Right?
Nah. That was Slick Rick influence.
That was Slick Rick influence.
Yeah.
And he acknowledged Slick Rick influence. That's dope.
That's because that's his man. Like that's his man,
yeah,
man.
Like
I love Slick Rick.
So you know what I'm saying? Shit rub off.
Yeah.
And it kind of looked kind of crazy. Cause like y'all, he biting the shit out. You know what I'm saying?
But they was men.
Right.
People compare you and your voice to Rakim. I think you and Big Daddy Kane had more.
I heard that. I heard that too.
You know, y'all both was related.
Hold on, Granddad. Fuck that. You may throw me out my own crib. Did anybody have to step in the right for you in your heyday?
What?
She.
Yo, Big Man like that. Yo, he said what? He said never. All right, hey, some rappers get a little writer's block. He said, nah, G, not me.
I had writer's block.
But you figure it out.
Figure that shit the fuck out.
Can you be considered the best if you don't write your own rhymes?
To me, no.
Cause we was just looking. We did the research and we seen that Drake is the artist with the most top tens in Hot 100 history. And admittedly, he write with other people, but he's number one. Madonna's under him, the Beatles is under him.
Let me tell you something, man. From the streets, I've been around the whole world, I've been around, Ron know, you know, I can tell you I've been around. Drake is rapping my shit that don't happen in Canada. Happen in Canada.
How you gonna say that?
Because, are you kidding me, Ron? I've been in Canada.
Come on,
Ron, he's saying shit that I've been through that I know. He got a tough motherfucker who's been running around the streets the whole life, who's feeding him the shit. He's a very smart dude, and he's putting it together right. Nothing to take from Drake. He's a beast. But I don't wanna.
But Canada, though, Canada got hoods too. Ron, so
I'm not saying that, but not the same language. His language is a New York language. Well, that's the shit
I just want y'all to look up on YouTube some shit, Drake and the fucking tuna sandwich.
And who?
The tuna sandwich.
I'm on it.
Oh, yeah, I gotta
look that shit up. I ain't that sort.
It's gonna be funny?
Yes.
The tuna sandwich.
Tuna.
Sandwich.
Tuna sandwich. Okay. Like tuna fish?
Look up tuna sandwich.
I didn't buy you that sandwich. I bought chicken salad. I'll make you a sandwich. I bought some other things.
Why didn't you just come?
Because the lineup was incredible. the great sandwich. Well, give me a chance here. Well, maybe you can help me then. Aubrey?
Something else you want to ask you to do, real MC. Really rap.
That's a rap.
Everybody we had on here really rap. We get your top five.
I don't really have no top five.
And cause your history spans so
it's
long.
It's a lot of motherfuckers. But like my favorite of all time is Kool G Rap.
Yeah, he's underrated. He was underrated.
And that's my man.
Remember that record, Talk Like Sex?
For the ladies, 195 pounds of beef. Chinky eyes, curly hair, gold teeth. Swinging with this here stud, you need practice. I'm leaving floods of blood on your mattress. I'll leave your hole in your swollen back, silent rolling. Filling all three holes just like bowling. Don't ask me what the price is, but it's more than your battery operated devices. And I come fully equipped with a temperature adjustment to heat up the tip. For demonstrations, watch me slammer. Now notice the sound of steady pounding like a jackhammer. Once ordered, you can't cop out. I'm pounding you down until your eyeballs pop out.
He scored so many other Big Pun. Nas. I used to go to the Kool G Rap crib. Nas be sitting in there writing and shit. Before any, you know what I'm saying, before Illmatic and all that shit.
Some were just sitting there writing.
Yeah.
But something about Kool G Rap, people didn't like, because he didn't sell no records. I used to look it up to Run, he sold 50,000 units on one of his best.
He was the streets.
The street rappers who sold records?
We loved him. I walked down Parsons Boulevard, I walked to Hillside in Suffolk, and they had a tape store, and I went and bought Roads of the Riches.
Yo, look at a old Vlad interview when he talked about the first time Pun met him. He said Pun dropped to his knees and kissed his ring.
Damn. I believe it.
What happened when you first met Big Pun?
Oh, Pun, yeah. Pun got down on one knee, grabbed my hand and kissed the ring and all that. And I mean, I was blown away by that, because he definitely, you know, Pun come. Even back then, Punk came across like a real cat, you know what I mean? So, I mean, it just blew me away, you know what I'm saying? I was like, that's how you know a man is completely confident within himself.
I believe it. And then when we talked about the girls, and then look at how he have a girl, and the girl just, you know, and you still can't shit on his legacy. He's dope. You know what I'm saying?
Nah.
Kool G Rap is, yo.
Kool G Rap, one of the illest rappers of all
time. Even Eminem gave him his props.
On Eminem, I told Ron I was on the stage of Eminem. He's about to perform. He said, yo, you think I could get Jay-Z's autograph? I said, Jay-Z's autograph? You want the top MCs? I don't give a fuck. Without him, I wouldn't be here. So I don't know if he got the autograph, to be honest with you, but I remember that, Ron.
I don't.
God is my witness.
I don't understand why people say he's one of the top MCs.
Eminem?
He can rap. He got more than me.
I'll agree. I just had this conversation with my boy.
I truthfully don't understand.
I don't either.
And that's not a knock to him.
You don't think he's top 10 at least?
I don't think he's top 10.
He killed him. First off, I think what helped him out too, every battle he had, he addressed.
That's battle. What about songs?
And he beats up on his mom on all the songs. Digging graves.
I never understood his. I can't relate to his content.
I'm an Eminem fan.
None of that
shit. His first album, the real
shit. He put a lot of words together. But if you go back and listen, a lot of them words don't actually rhyme.
Right.
Contorting the shit to make it rhyme.
No, he's off beat, right. So he does that on purpose. I think that's his style. I used to tell Jay that. He rhymes weird. Like, it don't even match.
It don't matter. I ain't talking about on beat. I'm talking about actually rhyming.
He's actually saying
He makes some shit try to rhyme that don't actually rhyme.
But it's the way your man rhymes like that.
Oh.
Ghostface
is. Don't ever talk about Ghostface.
Y'all know what I just said to you. Ghostface rhymes off beat and he rhymes weird.
Wait, I seen a couple faces.
We ain't talking about that. We talking about
you said the words don't know. I'm not a rapper. Hold up, but I ain't know. I'm not a rapper, so I'm not in the level of him because he raps. What I'm saying, you just said the words don't match like cat and hat. Right. Like in that sense?
Yeah.
He twists it right to make it match. Every rapper has their own style. I'm an Eminem fan, so I'm a little biased.
But why do you think Ghostface not dope?
I just said he's super dope, and he rhymes on beat, and he doesn't match everything either. Like, he's saying cat and hat, whatever. I'm not a rapper, so I don't care. I ain't no fucking rapper. I'm a motherfucking A&R / ghetto journalist.
All right, but wait. So let's go. You was the A&R.
Yes.
You was the A&R when Cam did
something new.
When he did something new remix, when he did something new over.
Oh, I say gonna be a, you
right,
know what?
Right.
All right.
I got the story, so tell us.
I remember the story now, but he got me. He said that fucking Big Face is a liar.
Tell the story.
I remember, he refreshed my memory. I don't remember the exact studio, but I definitely did tell him he was gonna be in the remix, because that's what they told me.
So Cam was doing something new over.
Remix.
Right. Yeah. And he was gonna have Granddaddy
I.E. Yes.
And you
promoted it.
So what happened? How'd you drop the ball on Cameron and Granddaddy I.E.
I'm telling you, I don't like to lie on myself. That everything says the truth. But I remember to this point, if that didn't happen, it wasn't me.
I heard this shit on the radio. I'm like, this motherfucker here.
Bust her eyes hot. Get in my drop. She said, why? I'm like, why not? Where you wanna go? To Waffle House, aha. I sit your head in my lap, meet Cyclops.
Hey ma, I'm feeling your style. Classy type chick standing out of the crowd. Gucci work, telling me gonna skirt. Your girlfriend loves to flirt.
She flirt, yeah. She fly. She cute. She ride in what? In coupes. She's true, she nice, she rude, but she still wants something new.
Look how the world is, man. 20 years later, you remember. That's why I try to keep my fucking word in my life. I'm going to say to you in front of everybody, I was just getting my weight up. I wasn't the man to make the decision.
I couldn't make it happen.
No, because I was told it was going to happen.
Right.
You understand, Ron? You tell me something's done.
Right.
Because I know, yeah, go ahead, man. Enjoy yourself.
He was like,
yo. Ron, you told Ron, I know. But the new Gary is a boss. A real boss. Because when I got with Ruff, I got out of jail. I was trying to figure myself out. And you get out of jail making 50 grand a year in 1999 with no degree. You're winning.
Right. You're winning big. Right.
So, Ron, my point was.
And all the perks that came with it.
I got a lot of perks. I'm not going to talk about that. I don't care.
Yeah, of course.
He talked about his
but
perks.
Me and me talking.
Speaking of perks, what kind of perks you had? You had some perks.
Yeah,
man,
that's a fact. That's a fact. Everybody in the industry did.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? If you ain't getting no money, you got the perks.
Yo, I was getting meetings for Dame, getting 4,000 just for a 20 minute meeting. Big Face Dame said, get all that money, man. Get that money. So there was perks, man. Now, he's one of my friends and one of my best friends. I don't talk to him a lot, but I love him. I brought him in. He came up to the studio one day. I thought he was talking shit. Little short motherfucker Bula talking my head off. Like, I could produce. Like, get the fuck out of here. So, your granddaddy, his dude was so he wouldn't even stop. Right. So, he went in the studio one day. I even forgot the first record to produce for me. He was waiting for me downstairs. Ron Quad. That's what Tupac got shot.
Right.
He came up. I said, man, I'm tired of your shit, man. What you got? He came upstairs, Ron. I was drunk. Big Ron, that motherfucker hit that machine. I said, oh my God.
Yeah, he was a beast.
Monster shit, Ron. Yeah. Like, monster. I call it mortuary music. Like, that dirty, underground shit. And I said, you with me now. Ron.
And he had a soulful swing to the shit.
Yes, and he was with me. And you know, Ron, you know Bula produced, I actually about 16 records of Rockefeller. Easy. He did about 8 on Bula. He did one for Neo. He did a bunch of Young Guns records all through me. He's talented. So that's your man. Now he told me throw parties. Motherfucker, man.
He's kind of my crib, you know what I'm saying? Before all that shit. Like, watch me on the SP and
that's
shit.
That's my boy. Oh, word?
Yeah, buy all records from me and all that shit.
But he don't work off of SP. Bula do
it. This was before that.
Oh, because Bula working for 3000. He likes a college. He never told me. I don't know if he did, but that dude right there.
That's why I was there in the studio that when I saw you. Cause I had to give him the motherfucking the goddamn instrumental to this shit.
Oh, for the grand. Oh,
yeah.
Yo, bro.
Bula called me. You know what I'm saying? So
I remember that shit, man. I feel like shit right now. Cause he's right, Ron. I was getting my weight up. Shout out, I'm gonna get emotional, man.
That's why.
Yeah, he said this fucking lying motherfucker.
This nigga lying ass nigga.
You wanna stop in
Cause it's yo, true. Yeah, you dropped the ball on the rest of us. Would have loved to see.
And Cam told me it was good, but after that says that Cam was signed to The Rock, but Cam was his own boss. I ain't gonna front. He do what he want to do. He was signed. Jay and them got their money, whatever money they made. But Cam ran his own shit. Cam, I remember what happened. Plus, I ain't doing it no more. I don't know what happened.
Hey,
but he's
man.
Right though. I definitely was like, that's. I learned now. I'm glad you said it to me because we just had a situation with something, and Ron told me stop trying to be nice all the time. Just be straight up. I don't know if I'm gonna do that, bro.
No more slow no's.
No, yeah, that's what we call a slow no.
You know, so you know sometimes somebody say something to you and you be like, I don't know, I probably get you
already. In your head, you already know, I'm not fucking with that shit. But now he was like, he was a gung-ho, like, yo.
But now I'm thinking about it, that was the dumbest move, Campus. He would have killed that something new remix. He was right. He's a rapper. Now, this might sound dumb, I don't even know this one. I'm gonna keep it real. You produce something new?
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't know. Okay, great record. Now, so shout out to Bula. I love you. You made me look real good at Rockefeller, man. Damon loved you too, because Bula was coming in. He followed my lead. One thing great, he had a work ethic. And he said to me, I'm not a producer. I said, you nasty. Yo, G, if I tell you something, you're gonna laugh at me. My producing is some hood shit. My shit is terrible, the way I produce, but it works for me. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Absolutely.
He said he's not like a Pharrell.
Yeah, he's not like a technical.
He said he's
shit.
Not technical. He said just, my shit is you know so
you got
dirty.
Your way
Ron,
of doing
he said if you teach. Ron, he said if somebody tell him teach me how to produce, he said he can't.
Right.
He don't even know how to produce. How to teach it. He just get it.
Just get it. Exactly.
That makes sense?
Yeah.
Exactly. He just get it. Yeah.
If it was an old school battle, they was talking about this too. I want to talk about this too on our show, right?
All
right. If it's an old school battle, what y'all want to see? It could be one of the old joints, LL versus Big Daddy Kane, Big Daddy Kane versus Rakim.
That'd be a good one.
What'd be a dope one that you would want to
see? Big Daddy Kane, who would be a good one? Rakim?
Yeah.
They got an ongoing little thing.
No disrespect, Rakim or demolished Big Daddy Kane.
I'm saying, first of all, back then,
Daddy Kane had all the bitches, he's dancing, he fucking anything moving, he got that. But you want to talk that shit? Like me and Ron got a rule, Ron love this, I Ron, Jay-Z gave a Bible to being in the streets of Reasonable Doubt.
Yeah.
A lot of people came up to me and said, G, without Jay, I wouldn't be where I'm at.
Yeah.
Ron said, G, I hate to admit it. Ron said, I'm not a dick rider, G.
I just make it real official when it comes to hip hop.
Yeah.
Let's go.
But I say, let's go. 50 and Jay-Z shit.
Nah, hell no.
He'll demolish Big D. He'll demolish 50.
You got enough.
You got a lot of records. Jay got a lot of records, man. And he's a way
better. I want 50 records.
Fifth got a lot of hits.
No, Fifth, he got me around. Let me tell you some records Fifth got, though, I'll agree with you, that can keep up with Can I Live. That's one of my favorite Jay-Z records. Many men, they pounding on me. What? That shit give me the shivers. But Jay got record after record after record after record after record.
Hold on. Only thing I'm saying is, that will be meaningful.
Oh, that you're right. Yeah. It'll be over 20 minutes. It'll be over 20 minutes, but you're right.
No,
it'll be about 20 minutes.
The way the state of everything.
I'm gonna make a 50 guy.
Hold on. Let me explain.
And the whole G Unit. Let's see.
Because you could battle, like when the coronavirus was going on. Yeah. They gotta be in the same room.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying?
But Jay too rich. He ain't doing that.
Man, listen. It'd be good for the people. I'm talking about lyrics.
Lyrics?
I'm talking about lyrics.
Or hits, because they kind of do the hits.
All right, lyrically, we're not going to talk about it.
Nobody ain't fucking with Jay-Z. No niggas out right now.
Just Biggie and Biggie.
Ron. No nigga out right now.
He's absolutely
right. We battle, yo. This my man. When I told you, Herbie Granddaddy, are you a legend? Jay-Z is the top dude.
I respect
he talking, he walking. Come on, man.
You got lyrics, so we gotta take that.
That's how I judge niggas by lyrics.
Oh,
if you talking about songs,
Granddaddy IU is dope, but you talking about catalogs? Nah. You talking about Jay-Z?
He don't even want that shit. He said, "Nah, I can't do that." Jay-Z, no disrespect to you. Jay-Z a god MC.
If you talking about multiple, you talking about just straight rapping, both of them bar for bar?
No, I'm talking about musically.
Hold his own.
All I'm saying is this, I lived it, not because I'm biased. Ron, you agree, we battle, but Ron bows down, G. All right, Biggie's gone, but besides Biggie, I have to give it to you. Me, Ron said, G said, you're fucking Jay-Z is a monster.
Well, hence that got spinners. Let's talk about that.
Prodigy from the stack. One of the top rappers at one point. Are you kidding me?
Who you said from the stack?
Method Man.
Meth from the stack?
I love Method Man.
Oh, yeah.
Method Man played too much, though, when he
rapped. Raekwon.
I don't know about
Raekwon from the stack.
Raekwon from the stack?
Nah, I never heard that.
Yeah.
We gonna have to fact check that one.
That ain't coming from me. I check my research through the boy Ron the researcher. I don't do that.
Hey, man.
Method Man, absolutely. On my album right now, he tell you that. He said, back on 100 Terrace Ave. That's his first boss.
Back on 100 Terrace Ave, it was me and little sister Missy. She my better half, man. I wonder if they miss me and the things we never had. Was too young to understand it, so I ain't never asked. Respect and I demand it. Go hard on every task. Got in trouble and got scars from each and every lash. Pain real in my bars. Ain't living in the past. Rather living in five stars than sitting in a class or sitting behind bars. I'm sticking to my path to a place where concrete look different from the grass.
Hold on. Now I'm getting on my gutter shit. It's Fly Ty Rich off Jerking People.
He ain't even rich right now.
See, that's why I like that answer. He ain't trying to front for him. Because me and Ron said he had all the artists.
He had everybody.
He got to be rich. He ain't telling you he rich.
I'm telling you not. I'm telling you
he's not rich. All
right. That nigga called me like every... Right now, we doing a series, a 13-part series and shit. Me, him, and Craze. I don't know if you know about Craze, the King of Content.
Yeah, of course.
Right. Shout out to you, Craze.
Yeah, that's... That's my man right there, my
boy.
Shout
out to him. I was trying to watch your whole interview and shit. You got a documentary, a story of granddad.
Yeah, he did everybody's story. Now he just got put on with PBS, Channel 13.
Oh, wow.
Those series is on Channel 13 with the cursing and everything.
What?
Yeah. So he got like a lot of different plugs. So we've been working on this shit for a minute. But it's
love real hip hop. Shout out.
So it's the story of Mr. Magic and Fly Ty. And the Juice Crew goes back to the Disco Fever days.
I don't know if weed being burned. I don't like what's going on.
Before the regular, before
right. I don't even smoke.
Members.
Right. What's the weed at?
Everybody think that the Juice Crew started with Coke Chillin'.
That's one of weed in my show, man. Run.
Mr. Magic was the first DJ that brought hip hop to the airwaves.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? It started out with HBI, and then he went to BLS.
Okay.
So it was a fight. You know what I'm saying? They were like, what is this bullshit? We don't want this shit on our motherfucking radio station. Tranky Crocker and them niggas at that time.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So he was like, all right, I'm going back to fucking HBI.
Right.
So then the upper echelon was like, nah, get that nigga back. We need that shit because the shit was so pop, the shit exploded. You know that?
Yeah.
So he came back. So everything that came on the radio had to come through him. So that was being that was the case. He could make a phone call and say, "Yo, I got a demo from my man. I'm gonna send him over there. You sign him, whatever record label it was, sign him. And I'm gonna play it on the radio. So you guarantee, you know what I'm saying, to recoup, get your money.
That's sweet.
So
right there.
Every from Houdini, he put Houdini together. So many artists, like all the foundation artists, had to come through them."
So why he dissed Crip KRS like that?
He dissed him because he didn't write that shit. That's how he is. Mr. Magic tell you, suck my dick.
What Fly Ty from?
Brooklyn.
He just a rude motherfucker. He didn't give a fuck.
No, Fly Ty is cool. It's Mr. Magic.
Very disrespectful. He don't give a fuck.
That nigga bad. Nigga, I'm super rocking Mr. Magic. Fuck you, suck my dick.
Damn. Was you around when the beef first started? When Mr. Magic dissed him and all that?
Nah, nigga. At that time, I was taping the shit on my motherfucking...
Putting the
tape
paper.
That. Right.
We told you this. Put the tape.
Right.
That was my
shit, yo, Ron.
Right.
Crazy.
So, when I got the Cold Chilling, you know what I'm saying? Not for nothing, God bless the dead, you know, he was already, you know, on the decline and shit.
Yeah.
But, you know... The legacy is still what it is.
It's stamp.
So, you know what I'm saying? That's what we bring into this the documentary. It's not documentary because it's gonna be acted out, Tyrone telling the stories.
But yeah. All right, but my thing is like I'm looking at the game right now, yo. You still here?
Right.
I'm still here. I had to reinvent myself through other shit. You fighting. How do you feel about a kid come out Monday? And he getting a show for 100,000. A rapper. That shit don't make you a little bitter?
Nah.
I don't feel as bitter, but I'm not even a hater. But I'm like, damn, can y'all put all the old rappers together and throw us 7 mil or something and let us do something else? Because without y'all, they didn't have the pavement was moved through y'all.
My thing.
Y'all made the pavement,
my
man.
My thing is this, I love for them to get their money, but I wish that they would do they research and understand the game and try to bring something more to the game instead of, like, everybody sound the same.
Then what buy you don't even know that you one of the main reasons they get money.
Yo, I hate that shit. Yo, I was at a spot one time and fucking Kool Herb couldn't get in the club.
Don't do that. I see Ron, you would have did if I was there?
Me too.
Out of black. Not out of black. You don't know my style. Out of black. I'd have put my phone over around this Kool Herb. He major. Yeah, how they stupid?
Some shit, yeah.
No, you don't mean that, right?
Yes.
That's disgusting.
Some other nigga came in, right in, cut the line, boom, right in.
That's disgusting. Work.
Yeah, so I'm like,
that's no.
Yeah.
Of course, one of the reasons this thing's here. Melly Mel.
That's hurtful.
Yo.
Kumo D.
This is what I'm saying. This is
Cat.
What.
Yo, that shit happened to me before.
Cat get money right now. He get money.
Cat's doing good. Oh, that's good to hear. What's Cat doing?
I love he touring and shit. He touring with Russell Peters.
But fortunately, I will say, I don't go out that much, but I will say fortunately in Manhattan, I'll say, most of the time, anyway, they let me in if I go out. They like, God, I don't know if it's still me.
Because, nigga, you got a distinguished face.
Yeah, like, I got a big face.
Big face.
Yeah, look at this big face guy merchant. Look at big face. Yeah, yeah.
You can't not notice it.
They let me in, Granddaddy. Let me in, man.
This nigga's hilarious right here. Like,
yeah. Thank you, man. I'm all right. Yo, but listen. So right now, the main thing you're doing, the compilation.
Right.
See, me and him battle. Me and him are done. Me and him and Big are dying to get artists. But we are so picky. We can't grab what we want. So I have a lot. You honest, I would do Beanie Siegel, Young Guns. I was around Jay-Z. I was around Cam. You gotta come with it for me. Am I wrong?
Yeah, now you're absolutely right.
And he has a good ear. Big.
Absolutely
so
right.
If me and Ron us get a battle artist, that means he ready. Because me and Ron. Ron is like, Ron's right, nasty. Listen, Ron is nasty with him, man.
So if you get an
artist. That's what I said.
If you get an artist, can you make it happen, though? In this climate.
That's my biggest fear, Ron.
In this climate.
And that's my biggest fear, because the kid is relying on me to make him big.
Right.
That's the problem. See, Ron? Yo, that's a big time question.
Yeah.
Ron, that's my biggest fear. Can I make it happen? This new era is different for me, Ron.
Right.
When we was doing it, Jay-Z, y'all. It was just putting out a record and going to war, and hopefully it grabs. Now he's on social media, you're on.
Right.
That's why I wish I was cool that Black's old head. He'd be rich, he'd be on. He still got money, but he fucked his career up.
He's still locked up, right?
Yeah, he made every wrong move. And he's Haitian, you know, I'm a big Haitian, so I love being
young. That's why you love Bula.
Yeah.
He was on Big L joint. We had it all from BMC. Seemed to be on the Big L joint.
Right.
We had McGruff, you know.
Big L, McGruff. Shout out to McGruff. Thank you. Shout out, baby.
Big L all day. Shout out, man. Lord Finesse. You know what I'm saying?
Curious George.
That was a dope ass interview.
Curious George one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was my. See, that was real comfortable. I grew up with them dudes. Like, they're from three blocks of me. You like that one?
Yeah,
we grew up big time. I'm just getting started, man. I'm still shy. People think I'm not, but I'm shy at certain shit. Like, I didn't know you that well, but now I'm an hour in, I'm starting to feel better and better. Like, I know him too, Big. I can't figure it out either. I know his face too. I'm going to grab it. It's going to come.
Your boy Fame on the compilation.
Oh, that's my man too. Yeah. Fame, Billy Danzini and Fame? Woo.
I got Rod Digger, I got Method Man, I got fucking Bumpy Knuckles.
Yeah, yeah, she's a little cute. If you're mad, I'm sorry. You're a little cute. She is a little cute.
He got Babs, yo. You gotta be proud of Babs with the king and the queen in the ring.
That's my sis. I love
her. She had a rap though. Is it against her contract or rap?
Yeah, she on his. She on.
No, he told, but he said she's not
battling. She ain't rapping on the
queen. No. That's her shit.
Oh, she's a boss.
Oh, she a boss. Her shit.
She own that.
She dope.
God bless her, man.
All right. Shout out to Official.
Shout out to everybody want to be their own boss. That W-2 shit is over. $10.99.
Fuck out of here.
$10.99. That's it, man. I ain't mean my man Ron been through big. I'm not knocking nobody. It's a little harder, but you don't have to walk into work one day and we don't need you no more.
Right.
Them days is over.
It's definitely harder. It's definitely harder, but
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Once you get it. It means it's more.
Yeah,
it means
more. You got that compilation, man. It's gonna pop, so you got to put it all through the waves. I actually wish you'd have brought some songs with you. I'd have previewed some of your songs on the show.
Well, we're gonna play
on my phone.
We could go through the Ron.
The Genius Corner, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, put it together for us. Yeah, yeah.
Yes, he is.
So how was it working with Fame and them? Nah, I worked with them. It took me 2 weeks to get a song. You know why? They're very particular how they do their songs. M.O.P. They just don't rap and leave, Ron. They gotta control this room. They gotta convince. Am I lying?
Nope.
Ron, no, Ron. You're not listening. Am I lying?
Nope.
Ron, it can take about 3 years to get one song.
It was 1 day. It was 1 day.
He drove me crazy, man.
But they were right though. He was like, hold up, stop.
Yeah, because they produce. And Fame's a producer, not Billy.
Fame.
He's a producer. Yes. You produce. Yes. Ron, every little thing, he know, yo, no, stop. No, it's not right.
Get the fuck off me. Trauma laws and tomahawks, I'm an offspring. Steady flow, we burn block for the steady dough. Yeah, we on a whole different level though. What's up?
This what I'm about. Body something quick, no doubt.
Pop's been running through my veins ever since. Grab the mic and represent.
Grab yourself more.
It's not right. You know what I mean? So, he's a very difficult.
Yeah. This nigga got me drinking
Ultra Michelob. Yo, make this a fucking check, because I don't like giving out my shit.
Like Alka-Seltzer.
Yeah, I'm saying, look at his face, though. His face is up here, and now it's getting slower and slower down. Because, yeah, it's just kicking it.
That's this right here.
Thing. Don't tell me what it is there, though.
That's this right here.
Because they can't get money off of it. They got to give me a deal.
Right.
I want a deal. Pay me some money. So, now, the new era, I'm a ghetto journalist, so I'm not going to lie. My
man, how you feel about the new dudes with the dresses and they saying they wear dresses because they keep the AKs on their dresses and they got a purse because they keep the hammer in their purse and all that? You know
that shit. I'm not with none of that bullshit.
None of that bullshit.
You know what I'm saying? Like if you got to do that to get money, man, get you another profession. To me. Because this shit right now, we in social media age. This shit ain't going nowhere. You know what I'm saying? You gonna see it. That shit, that footage is gonna be around forever. When your kids grow up and look back at you, when you offer that shit, and you got dropped from the label and all that shit, you back to your regular self.
Your kids gonna be
looking at you like, daddy, what the fuck was you doing with the dress? You know what I'm saying?
Tekashi painted. I don't even know that kid. He killed his kids. It's just crazy what he did. I don't want to go back because I usually go back on my shows on stuff, but
and he down with your boy Academics.
The cool one?
Really, nigga?
No.
Academics is just like, Academics.
Ron, no, violence. I'm talking about shit. I don't know.
Academics is, he got a huge platform. For all of the new people that maybe see, we gonna have a show. I'm gonna tell you about. We want to invite you back, but we gonna have a screen. We gonna talk about some of this new music, and we gonna have some MCs, some real MCs here talking about what they think of this new music. So it's gonna be a couple dudes with dresses on. It's gonna be some little noddies, and it's gonna be some. Now, just being musical, you gotta see the beauty in something. So dude got 18 joints. I'm sure he been produced by somebody dope. They done paid $100,000 for an ill track. It might be something you could vibe to and all that. But there's a lane for old school dudes, for dudes who could rap, for boom bap. How you feel about Griselda?
I fuck with that. I fuck with them.
38 Special, yeah. All them like that. More like, yo, that, dude, New York, I honestly don't listen to none of that shit. I hear it when I hear it, I respect it,
that's some shit.
Right.
Do I go back and buy it, or do I go back and play it again? No.
You haven't had anything to have replay value right now.
Nah, because you know why? I'm from an era where I heard everything they saying multiple times. Like nobody right now is saying no shit that Kool G Rap didn't say, no shit that fucking, you know what I'm saying? M.O.P. didn't say, you know what I'm saying? That shit's all recycled lyrics, you know what I'm saying? Saying it in a different way.
My joint, I be listening to right now, new, I be listening to Lil Baby. Take a chance if you ever get a second.
You know who my man is? Rock Marcy.
Okay.
And that's my man.
That's lyrics. That's why. Right. He's from the town.
I'm a Manhattan motherfucker.
He's from the town.
See, I'm different.
To Rock Boss.
I'm a Manhattan motherfucker. I like how they flaw. I'm a Young Dolph fan. You know, I'm a Young Dolph guy.
I don't know who I know who you're talking about, but I couldn't tell you one song.
Yeah, he got 100 shots. He got a bunch of records. He
talked crazy. Dolph ain't a rapper.
Know who I do like? Know who I? Somebody's put. I was. I'm gonna tell you the truth.
Nipsey Hussle.
Oh.
I wasn't up on him. Ooh. Everybody was talking about him.
No, no, don't you do that. Don't you do that.
Nah.
Because he was okay, Ron.
No,
okay.
I finally listened to him. Oh. I fuck with him.
You got to start working.
No. First of all, I didn't say he can't rap, but we're not going to. He just says stuff that makes sense in the world and what's going on.
Let me pose a question. Yeah. I got to pose this to the boss over there.
Yeah.
That's what I was talking to all the time.
Bye-bye.
You ever thought about getting a basketball team? Or do you got a basketball team yet?
Nah, fuck that guy to do with it.
He tried. He actually about to try and think. I think he's got confidence in you, thinking that you think you have the skill set to get a team. It's on no damn NBA. You ain't no billionaire. That's what it costs to get an NBA team or whatever. Nah. I know he's not talking about.
He talked probably about like how Bobito
like at the Rocker type
And how Finesse loved basketball, and he coached.
Why I like him? Because he's a big fan of him. How you're a big fan of me?
You're a big fan of Rockefeller.
Yeah, I'm always gonna be a big fan of him. I just keep it real, man. You know, it was way more good than bad. But my thing is, like you just said, like the rap game. Like I keep going back to this because it's anything about this, they don't respect their OGs, man.
Right.
That's what's nasty.
Right.
Shout out to Kool Herc. They should be shout out to Melly Mel. Shout out to Kool. Shout out to Jay-Z.
Yeah.
These rappers, they wouldn't be in Cold Crush Kool.
Saying all that.
Kool Mo-Z.
Some of the OGs take a little bit of blame. Because as parents, right, don't you got to school the youth as well? I just want to be honest. Don't you got to school the youth as well? Don't you got to pass the knowledge on and take them and nurture them and school them?
That's a fact.
But whose job was to do that, though?
And the people before them, the granddaddy I used, the big daddy came.
Well, my joint, I got multiple young artists on
there. Yes, you do.
That I brought to the game, you know what I'm saying? And told them, listen, it's the alley you take it and run with it.
And
I made sure all of them had it publishing correct and all that, you know what I'm saying? So
back in the days, the publishers were crazy, probably, man. They ain't even let you know, huh?
Man, what? I'm gonna fuck this nigga up if he don't.
That's a weird ring too. That shit made me nervous.
Old school
shit. So like I said, a new era. You got a compilation out, and you're waiting to see how it goes independently.
Right.
And you guys should love him because I've been in the game for years, and no one puts out a group and don't make you sign no paperwork. So that means he's in the best interest of y'all.
Right.
So y'all don't be no suckers. Get on that crazy. So if y'all get on the 16 bars for his movement, yo, you gotta call my manager.
What?
No. Yeah, we're not doing that.
Nah.
That happens, though,
wait,
right?
Does it happen?
I want to ask y'all this. What y'all think about the Vlad TV shit?
I think that people get on Vlad because it's a platform like this. You can't blame Vlad for asking the questions. We had tragedy, say you have a choice, right? Mm-hmm. You have a choice to answer the question. So Vlad asks a lot of questions that can get people in trouble.
Interrogation.
But us as street people with street knowledge do have the choice.
But
to be like,
I'm saying, what you think of his line of questioning? Why?
I think he don't care about hip-hop.
Listen, if multiple people came on your platform and got locked up, why do you continue this line of questioning? When niggas come on your platform,
he's exposing people's pain.
So your man Dame Dash says that Vlad, you know his favorite word is culture vulture. You know I fuck with Dame.
Yes, he's saying
Vlad is a culture vulture because if you really cared about the culture, you wouldn't ask him the question.
Yes.
You wouldn't try to get people in trouble like that.
He's a sucker for that. Hold on, Ron. You don't have to look at me like that because I'm not on like Vlad. He's a sucker for that.
I'm not saying that.
I saw his face, the G. You got to say Vlad bigger than you.
No.
He gave me that.
No, I don't care about that. You don't care about nobody bigger, no number. Because
I ain't no shorties over here. I'm good. I pay all my bills with no problems.
I looked at you like, G, you a journalist now.
Yeah.
So if somebody come on and say they had gotten some trouble, right?
Yeah.
You can ask about the trouble. Right? But they don't have to answer it, right?
Yeah, you're
right. Is it your fault if you ask the question
and answer it?
And they say, yo, nah, 12 o'clock, I was on Siegel Street. I used to pump, I had 100 cracks.
Keep going and bring it out of you.
But they got to tell them, shut the fuck up then. Learn. See, think about me, I'm very smart. Yo, man, you asked me that. See, I embarrassed somebody on camera. You asked me that 3 times. I'm not going to give what you want to hear. Stop asking me the same question.
You got to have somebody here. I'll be looking at you.
And I'm not going to tell my secrets, but I have certain codes in my crew when, and, you know.
What was his purpose for keep digging, I'm saying?
See, Ron and Ron will be like, yeah.
Right now, the Fed is watching everything online. That's how they solve cases. They don't do no street work, and, you know what I'm saying? They solve cases online.
Yes.
So you know the Fed is watching.
Yes.
And you know that the Feds have infiltrated every movement that we ever created. You know what I'm saying? COINTELPRO still exists. So why would you not think that they infiltrated hip hop? You know they did already.
They did.
The nigga that wrote a book back in the days about the hip hop cop.
The hip hop cop. Yeah.
Hip hop police is real.
Well, let me tell you something, Granddaddy. I'm saying it on live because I'm not ashamed to say it. I'm focused on my show. I don't look at the internet like that. He does that for me because he likes to keep me up a toll. But now he said Vlad does that.
You gotta watch it.
No, I've watched Vlad's show before, but I just turn shit off for 6 minutes. Because but now that you tell me that, I'm gonna watch it. But, Granddad, I can keep it real with you. These guys, like Ron said, yo, don't ask me that question no more. Embarrass them if you feel the way. I'm not answering it.
You know who did that?
Who?
Fame.
Oh, he did?
Fame, like, nah.
But again, I got a team with me. He'd be like, Ron, give me a signal. Or Ron is gonna get rid of stop asking my man that same question, bitch. But that's it, it's not happening. You know? So basically what you're saying is, Vlad is exposing our culture, making money.
Right.
It's fucked up.
As your boy says,
and niggas getting locked up behind it.
Oh, they getting locked up?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to tell you.
I know AR rap is. God damn, I know who that is. You're embarrassing me. I know sometimes, like, he got a right to do that. Because there's sometimes he say shit to me, like, I ain't gonna lie, he got a right to say that. Because sometimes I'm bugging out. But I'm so into my show. Trying to get off shit big. But, yeah, Ron. So it's to that point, Granddaddy, that he can get you jammed up?
Yeah.
Okay, that's bad then.
And you know the Feds is watching, so why would you ask him questions?
Well, they need a stronger
but
team.
But then you got dudes on there still that's personalities that's black. Like, and pro-black. Like, Lord Jamar, right?
Yeah, he's
Lord
people.
Jamar's on there all the time, right? Lunel's on there all the time. He got personalities that's on there all the time. I kind of feel like for Vlad, like, that our brother should be smart enough. If you ain't going to make an answer in front of the police, why you going to make an answer in front of camera?
Right.
Are you going to make a sale in front of a camera and hope that the camera's off? You know what I'm saying?
But Ron, obviously it's working. But Ron, it's working for Vlad because, like I said, they not doing nothing about it.
You know why it's working? Because he got the biggest platform right now. Him,
he has a huge platform.
Him and the 22 Jumper, whatever the fuck. No Jumper.
There's No Jumper. No Jumper. Adam 22.
But you know what?
But Adam 22 don't really do
nah,
that.
Nah, he don't do that.
Adam 22, he don't do that. But Vlad is known for that.
Yes.
But you know what the thing is, though? This show here that I'm glad you're on, thank you for being here again.
Thank you so much.
There's a lot of principle in my show, and me and him have a lot of principle. Me and Big, we talk about a lot of scruples. Big, there's some things, like Big calls Ron, and Ron call me certain things. Ron, Big sees something he don't like. Yo, G, you may not want to do that. So we watch ourselves.
Right.
And, you know, me and Ron are bragging about it. We've been up that place that ain't cool. Like, you've been there. So right. We understand principle, man. Right, that's when Tekashi, we had a big argument with him over Tekashi.
Yeah.
No, he didn't like what he did, but he said, gee, it's the new era.
Nah,
we can't condone it.
We
just said
it's acceptable. We Ron said it's what it is.
We cannot let that shit be acceptable.
Thank you. Ron has a son. I asked him. Ron said, oh, no, I told my son, if you do something that's wrong, you have to be accountable.
I would never have my son have
that. You have a son?
Nah, I got a daughter.
Oh, you got a daughter. I got a daughter, too.
I would never have that my son have to live through something that I did like that. Morally, us from the school we from, we'd rather die than have our
name
smeared like that.
Right.
You go somewhere and somebody talking about you was
and granddaddy, I'm from an era too. You with your kid, they pull your kid to the side and blow your fucking head off for being a snitch.
Right.
I was born in 1970, I seen it.
Right.
So I know. You saw American Gangster when Denzel killed that dude in the streets?
Yeah.
And it was like it was nothing?
I need these fresh. If I come back here and get you, you know what it is.
Gango.
Yes, sir. Play that.
Yes, sir. I hear you. You won't have to come back. There will be no problem.
What about you, Frank? You need anything?
Where's my money?
Red Top gave you the package. He's supposed to be handing me my money. Here's a jar right here, 20%.
Oh, you got the jar?
That's right.
Get the fuck out of here, Frank. Oh, what you gonna do? What the fuck you gonna do, Frank? Huh? What you doing? You gonna shoot me in front of everybody? Huh? Come on.
That's what the era was
back then. But you're also from Manhattan. And Alpha had on the MCM, the MCM gloves on the Harley, skeeting out down the Lenox or something. You know what I'm saying? So that's even acceptable now. Yo, as it wasn't
before. You know why? This is my estimation. I think because Alpha became more than just
that.
A street legend. He like the movies, his whole
fucking, shit got blown up, man.
Yeah, his whole story is like, this nigga's bigger than life.
Yeah, yeah.
So niggas is in awe when you see him.
But to be able to walk to the place where you
okay, now, body, all right, you know, okay, that, so
if, I don't got a dog in the fight. Wait, I just want to say, you know what I'm saying?
But you said he got the MCM gloves on. He got the fucking the big ass. What it was, the Harley Davidson. Imagine he came home and he's a broke nigga just walking down the street. It would be a whole different story. You know what I'm saying?
So bottom line is this. I'm going to speak for me, and I can speak for you, and I can speak for you. When I got in trouble, I went to jail. I did my time. I learned my lesson. That's it. So that's Tekashi's business. But like Ron said, I haven't heard from him, so that plan might not work. The publicity stunt. Now, when your kid becomes 13 and he's in school, and the niggas, they swing on him, why are you swinging on me? Your daddy's a rat.
Right.
Everybody's grown who was around Alpha days. Nobody going to get in trouble.
It's all right. Yeah. With their family.
Yeah. Or some shit that back
it's
in the
over.
Days.
It's
you
over.
You going to jail, tell your daughter you locked up. Why? Because I punched somebody in the face that back in the 80s, they snitched on somebody who
somebody,
I don't even know.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That
So that era's over. My new thing is these rappers here need to pay homage to the hoes. Even Eminem, you don't want to hear it. He's been rapping 15 years. A lot, he paved the way for a lot of people too.
Yo,
Jack Harlow,
yeah.
He paved the way for all these. Like, is this a new era? And my thing is, just so like he said, cool. Herc couldn't get a
that
club.
Hurts.
If I was out of lost it though, you would have been mad. I've been
that
lost
hurts.
It. Do you really like that Jay the Fab battle, or you didn't really pay no mind?
Oh, he paid
much. Oh, I'm dead kiss.
Yeah, and Fab. What you thought about that?
It was aight.
That's
it
what
was,
I said,
it
man.
Was aight.
It was aight. Fab was too cool and Jay was drunk.
Yeah, Jay, that's why I
that's
like
me, Ron. Ron, you may rap better than me, but I'm more outgoing than you. So I'm going to talk crazy. Fab was on this. He had a Gucci shades. Yeah, I got Balenciaga shoes on with the tank top.
I take Jada.
That was nice. But, you know, all ladies, it's hard to find some of them that's genuine, that don't care about none of that, but to get some of them, this is what you need. Yeah, nigga.
I take Jada.
But Ron, I'm not saying it's a wrong battle. Ron talked about it too, though. But Ron said it too. Ron said, you can't rock. Fab Ron is an asshole. Fab got mixtape game that don't make no sense.
Who won? That's it.
Well, they said who won with Jada.
No, who you think won?
All right, I'm going to be honest with you. If they could do it right now, on paper, Jada won. And Jada's my man, and I like Fab a lot too. But Fab was just too cool that day. I don't know what happened, Ron. It's like he came from Miami, like, yeah, what's up, yeah.
He squashed the beef between
Styles P and Beanie Siegel.
He squashed the beef.
Yo,
that
wait,
was, that
wait.
Was right, crazy.
I
put that together.
Right. Who you think won that battle?
Me, Ron, so I'm going to tell you right now, that was a war.
He go on his Rockefeller.
No, it's a war.
Granddaddy IU.
Who's talking about Jadakiss and Beans?
Yo,
yeah.
IU.
Yeah.
What I said, Ron, like, what I said? Ron, I said it was a great battle, but Ron said he not gonna lie. Ron said Beans the way it's like the way they did it. He just kept rapping after time. Yo, shut up, man.
Yo,
shut up, man. You got more to say.
But Jada went to Philly on the stage at what's that? Philly.
Took him a lot of hard to do that.
Yeah,
he went hard.
And went hard. And won the pro.
Like I say,
yo,
Jada is one of the illest lyricists ever.
Yes.
But that battle, to me, when Beans did that shit over the, damn.
Damn.
Yeah, fuck the speculation, talk over. Nigga, dig this. I'm about to sun kiss like a soda and make J to the moi. Put his lips on his nine and really kiss the game goodbye. You about to really make me hurt you, kiss. Spitting candy bars. This nigga sweeter than a Hershey kiss. Got me heated about to work the fifth. Rezzing off that purple shit. The Reverend gotta get a hearse for kiss. You broke. Talking about you rock yourself out. When I see you going, really wish you knock yourself out.
Shit, he kept rhyming.
That was the one where he was, yeah, that's the one where he kept rhyming.
I was like, ah, shit.
Big time rapper, man. We talked about that, Ron. He did. Yeah. Got other issues. Big time rapper. Big time rapper.
Man.
You can't. How do you feel it now that, you know what I'm saying, after Beans, seemed like after Beans got shot, Beans though, after Beans got shot, that his voice kinda ain't the same.
Yeah, like, it's something you gotta say. You gotta deal with something like that, you know? You gotta deal with that situation, man, because I don't know, man. I ain't on Beans' best album, man. I felt he was one of the best ever.
Which one was that?
The Becoming. Feeling the air. Moolah did about 7 tracks on that album. Easy. It's the way things are. Like, things never... Me and Ron talked about that. Like, right now, I'm working on my podcast. I'm like 5 months in. Motherfuckers fronting on me. They're like, man, I'm killing the game. Then I might get bigger than you. And then now you want my help.
Right.
So my point is, Beans on the top of the world. And you never know when shit gonna die. So when you got it, you gotta stay on it. Jay Sinner's record, Beans, I'm not trying to change you. I'm trying to school you to the game. You remember the song I'm talking about?
Nah.
Ron knows what I'm talking about. Ron remembers every song, yeah. So my point is, unfortunately, his voice is not what it used to be. So if I was Beans, I'd just start ghostwriting people and get rich.
Right.
Because he can rap.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna name nothing. My stipulation gonna be, I'm never gonna say I wrote it. Just have my, but when I need cash, no IRS, 10 grand a song.
Because he can moss.
No, I'm in studios with Beans. Beans.
Hey, Grant, you think that's what ghostwriters is getting? The top ghostwriters right now.
They don't ghostwriter. I don't know who ghostwriters
right now. Hell no, niggas getting
a
money.
Top ghostwriter, because they said Rick Ross ghostwriter a lot of shit. I don't know. Right?
You know why I don't believe that? Because Rick Ross style is hard to ghostwrite for people, man. Because you gotta sell it too, man. You gotta sell it.
Yeah.
You can't just say you ghostwrite. You gotta sell it, man. You gotta sell it. I said Biggie running the camera. I told him how to run the camera. You let your student run the camera. And then the shit is all over the place. No, you gotta sell it. That's why I said Lil' Kim is a dog. Because they wrote it for her and she sold it. And that shit you did? See, I'm gonna bring this on. When you did it with her, did it take a long time to get it? It was hours in the studio or she caught it right away?
Nah, she definitely caught it right away. It was like, you know, it took a little minute, but because she was a little bit nervous at the time. Because
she didn't want the beef.
Because some of the shit was more than she anticipated.
You want some more Alka-Seltzer? Big, give him some Alka-Seltzer, man. Big, give him some Alka-Seltzer, man.
Oh, yeah. Shit.
Nah, this is one of my other great shows, man. I got a legend.
That
he's humble.
Said you want some more Alka-Seltzer.
He humble now, but they said back in the days.
Yeah, he was very arrogant. He wore your suits.
Even Ty said back in the days, he was like, it was an interview I was looking at.
Ron,
like,
Ron.
Granddaddy, you know, it was the same thing. He always was in and out of jail. He had thugs around him, you know what I'm saying? They said you was holding your own back then.
I was young, of course.
Yeah, I'm asking you a question. Are you still friends with these guys?
Yeah.
That grew up with you when you was a rapper?
The ones that still here.
Some of them not here no more.
God bless
you.
Like,
but the ones who are alive, they still your man to them.
Yeah.
Y'all hang out, drink, talk shit. You just like me.
Bubba Rufus.
Was one of your friends?
Yeah.
He's still around?
Yeah.
He in Long Island, we should be chilling?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Like a lot of niggas, you know, but. Most of them niggas is dead or they, you know, huh?
Do you even show love to your other Juice Crew member on here? You produce. He tried to put a lot of jewels on, man. You did your thing, man. You really produced the shit out of that, man. The Essence.
Did you produce the whole Essence?
Everything.
Every track.
Everything.
So, for the young up and coming producers, what machines are you using?
Nope. I'm gonna tell you something.
But Moolah know though.
Nah, I ain't use no machines.
You fucking me up now. How you put this record without using no machines?
Nigga.
You play shit.
Nah, I use a fucking program.
Oh, the everything change?
Nah, it's just that I was fucking with this program from a minute ago. I got I got all that shit. But I was fucking with one particular program, and the shit's obsolete now. You can't even buy it no more.
And you still got it.
I still fuck with it, and I was like, I started the first beat with it. I said, you know what? I'm gonna make the whole shit on this joint right here.
Big question: Are you gonna have, or are you okay? Or are you just like if you try?
Now, why the fuck would
really,
you
ask? Really, nigga?
Because I'm trying to squeeze. I'm an A&R, so now I'm helping you because I've A&R a bunch of.
Don't ask me that shit on air.
All right, well, you know what? Put it. All right, I'm gonna ask you after. Well, no. You know what? We'll erase that part. But I'm gonna help you because I don't want you get. I don't want you when you about to get a check for 240. Because you didn't follow the rules.
I
want you to win. You deserve to win.
So,
my thing is, I'm gonna be honest with you. I ain't never think I was gonna interview Long Island dude and draw myself because I got my certain situations.
Here he go with the Long Island Queen shit.
This was a great interview. I enjoyed my interview. We drank Alka-Seltzer.
We still drinking that shit right now.
Yeah, he got the Remy, his friends. It's with a lot of pot.
Yeah.
The Big Face Gary Show. Subscribe on YouTube.
Yeah, man.
Thank you for Ron, the producer. My man, the genius. His fellas. Thank you for coming to my show.
No doubt.
I love y'all. Thanks. See y'all soon, man. Next week, another surprise interview. Love y'all. Peace.
All right.
Scared money never made a dollar. For that moolah dudes, I put the Ruger to medulla oblongatas. As a youth, he played cops and robbers. Tell the truth, assaulting robbing. Got lots of brothers on Rockers Island. And God, we trust the devil is a liar. By any means acquired, that president's required. Gotta have it, no matter earn it or grab it. Put the cannon to your cabbage, sleeping with the maggots. It's not a game, niggas pitching underhanded. Hit or miss, three strikes, get sentenced then remanded. Pay your penance if you're sinning, living lavish. Chasing spinach, turn many men into savages. In the jungle, hunger pains be the catalyst. We bathe with the apes, watch for snakes and the scavengers. Time borrowed, the nine slugs hollow. Got money on my mind, the grind thugs follow.